you know, when you have in-state opportunities, Nichols, us, you know, I think one of us was going to be sent there. So not surprising at all. And it's just, you know, it's another opportunity to shock the world. And, you know, you play against a team you've already played once. And, you know, even though it was a midweek, which is certainly different when you're talking about the battle of bullpens most of the time on a midweek, you know, at least the mystery part is out of that. And so we've played them, they've played us. And so, you know, we're all different teams at this point. So looking forward to the opportunity to get up there and be able to be close for our fan base, to be able to get up there and have their butts in the seat and, you know, really relish in this opportunity. So looking forward to it for sure.
You said shock the world. Is that kind of the mantra at this point? I mean, can the new mantra, like, you got in now, like, shock everybody else, just keep going? Is that something that we'll hear all week from you guys?
I don't know if it'll be something that you'll hear all week. You know, certainly when you make comments or statements, you certainly want them to be authentic. So I don't want to overuse certain kinds of things. But, you know, I think all of us in this room know the struggles of the team this year and how that's gone in terms of the win-loss, not of their mentality or their will or their work ethic or those kinds of things, just the game and the results weren't kind to us for so long. So, but they never faltered, they never wavered. They believed and they prepared with purpose and intent. And, you know, I look at people's faces and their body language frequently to kind of figure out where they are. And I can tell you that I knew we were in a really great spot from the time that we got there. So they were purposeful in what they were doing. And, you know, we're going to do our very best to mimic that that environment again for us. And, you know, this week is done and it's time to move on to another thing. You know, it's something they'll remember for the rest of their lives, that, you know, that 5-day stretch. But, you know, we're five away from getting to the promised land, but you certainly got to handle, you know, the three other teams that are in front of you. So we'll get there when we get there, but just really, again, excited for the opportunity.
I think Tio had mentioned this yesterday, just how kind of the AAC tournament was a fresh start for this team. How much do you kind of feel like the postseason fresh start has kind of helped this team?
Yeah, and I think the way, you know, take out the, you know, the Friday or the Thursday and the Saturday against Memphis. I think the way that they kind of came together towards the end, and we started, it wasn't just solely dependent on, you know, our bullpen or our starting pitching. Our offense started to come around. So when you have kind of some signs of life that, okay, guys are starting to break out and there's some continuity in our lineup, we're getting some length to our lineup, and guys are starting to get comfortable, you know, it makes for confidence building, even though the results may have not said that on the outside. They were getting confident. And so we were preparing for that last non-conference or the last conference weekend of the series so that we could prepare our pitching for where it was when we got there, because there was no at-large bid. It was win the tournament or go home. And so that's what we were most focused on, and certainly trying to win those games. But, you know, in terms of a new season, yeah, you're 0-0. You know, anything can happen, and anything did happen. And it wasn't an accident. You know, it was purposeful and intentful, and the guys, they came to play. And like I've been saying from the very beginning, well, not the very beginning, but as the league wore on, just evaluating kind of where all the teams were, we just felt like there wasn't a clear separation of pitching and everybody else. So we had a chance. And so now you're in another opportunity where you're going to face some of the best teams in the country, and you know, that's what you sign up for. So anything can happen again in those kinds of environments. So.
Jay, I know you're talking about moving on, you know, the AAC tournament's done, that was a great accomplishment for you guys, and moving on to the NCAA tournament. Is there anything that you would like to, like, just bottle up from that run to, like, carry over into Baton Rouge this weekend?
Yeah, it's just their mindfulness and their purpose. I think when you're laser focused on kind of what you're doing and really being in the moment, and, you know, not letting you know, we run out in the championship game and throw up a three spot, and then we turn right around in an ugly bottom of the first and give them four back, for us to just be able to, you know, turn the page to the next inning and the next opportunities is really critical, and you know, for me, that's the kind of purpose that I want to see our guys continue to play with, not only for however long the rest of this season is for us, but as we continue to move forward.
Did all those road trips that you took early, did late February and early March pay off in May?
I hope so. I mean, that's That's what you hope. But, I mean, you certainly don't want to get off to a bad start, which we did, you know, and a lot of things didn't fall our way. But the thing that I think we ultimately, looking back to where we are right now, the thing that I think we're comfortable on the road, we're comfortable in adverse situations because we've had more than I care to probably ever have again in my life, and them too. But, you know, that's part of life, and baseball is a microcosm of life. Truly it is. And so the lessons that our guys have gotten from how this season has unfolded has been enormous, and so they've been through it all. So I don't think any of those kind of things scare them or put them in a situation where they're unfamiliar with. We're very unfamiliar, or very familiar with being uncomfortable, excuse me.
So. You have a relationship with Jay Johnson. I mean, obviously from Nevada, the West Coast,
yep.
You know, out there.
Yep.
Just your thoughts on him as a coach. And then, you know, sometimes when ones play four, they will not pitch their ace. Do you plan on just throwing everything, obviously, in game one?
I mean, we're going to go at it probably status quo. It'll be either, you know, Ricky or Dylan, just kind of depending on where they are with their bodies and kind of how we feel with the matchup. But we're not at liberty to have a stable full of ponies where we can slough the deck and try to save our best guy for the either the elimination game or the get into the, you know, the winner's bracket kind of thing. So, I can't speak for what they're going to do. I can certainly think about the things they're going to do if I was in their situation, and but that's for them. They're going to decide that, and whoever's on that mound or in their lineup, you know, we're going to need to make good pitches and play good defense, which is a component of championship baseball, you know, and get timely hitting, and when we get a lead, extend the lead, you know. So those are critical components of winning games. And you know, my relationship with Jay goes back a long, long way. When we were both assistants, he was at San Diego and I was at Oregon and Nevada, and so he's been a friend for a long time. And so, you know, you never like playing your friends. I think he said that, and I agree. But here we are, and so again, they're well coached, and he's got a lot of challenges within his environment that he's got to weather, and I get that, you know, so we'll look forward to seeing him on Friday.
If they choose to throw Paul Skeens, that is the ultimate challenge in baseball this year.
Yep.
They may or they may not. We don't know yet. Just what are your thoughts on that?
Yeah, I think it's a great challenge that our guys will want to be up to. I think anytime you face guys or teams or programs that are quote unquote the best at what they do, you know, those things are motivators. So I'm looking forward to watching our guys get the challenge of that. So excited about that.
Left-handers have given them a little bit of difficulty. Does that play into your?
Yeah, well, definitely the matchup part of that will be a key factor in deciding on who we're going to run out there first. For sure.
You mentioned pressure on top programs, Jay Johnson, anybody who's hosting. Do you feel like leadership for your team and your guys became a little bit more loose or in any way changed over these past couple of days and heading into this, just as far as vocal leadership, leadership by example?
I think we've had that from the beginning, but I think as the season wears on, you know, production oftentimes kind of determines the strength of your voice in the clubhouse. So we've had it. The older guys have done a nice job with it, and so, you know, we lean on them to be able to provide some stability in the clubhouse and a direction. It's one thing for me and our coaches to direct and try to steer the boat, but for them to be steering in the same direction is really important. So it, you know, feels like we've done that. So.
How do you spend a little bit of your career at Oregon? How just familiar are you with Oregon State and Sam Houston as well?
Very familiar with Oregon State. So, ironically, Tulane, LSU, rivalry, Oregon State, Oregon, rival. So, I'm right in the boat with a bunch of rivals. So, I get the emotions of that. And so, I'm well-versed with them. Not as much with Coach Canham because he was a player when I was coaching. Actually, when I was at Nevada coaching, we played at Oregon State several times, and he was a player, very good player, very good coach. So, more familiar with, you know, Coach Casey and his, the way he operates, but you know, the apple doesn't fall far from the tree in that deal. So they'll be well coached and tough and competitive, and so you know, I think all the teams in that region will have their hands full. Sam Houston's going to be tough and gritty, and an old friend, Eddie Smith, almost nipped them in the bud to get in the regional too. He's at Utah Valley. So yeah, it's going to be, it's a really tough draw. It's a great, opportunity to really go in there, play gritty, play tough, and see what comes out of that.
You know, the other Louisiana teams like Nichols going to Tuscaloosa and UL going to Miami, but is there any benefit to just going like an hour down the road?
Maybe, just because you don't have to, you get what we will get is an extra day of practice instead of travel. And so that part will be helpful, that we are close to home. And I've done it, when I was at Oregon, we went to UConn and flew across the country for that. So that's a whole different set of challenges as well. So there are some travel things that we're not going to have to deal with, which are positive things. But, again, it's going to be about handling our business and being ready to play in game one for sure.
You had the number 8 non-conference strength of schedule.
Yes, we did.
This year. I know that's next year, but will you rethink that, or will you run the gauntlet again?
I've got a, again, you never know how the RPIs or the scheduling will affect you from year to year, because some teams will be better, some teams will be worse. But I think I had the number. I'd have to go back and count now with the official count, but I think maybe 9 teams I thought potentially that we played this year were going to be in a regional. So, when you play the 8th toughest schedule, that's, it's tough. So we'll see. I don't, how it's softened. I think we'll play some more home games, more regional games next year. So
there can be a tendency when you expend so much emotion to get to this point for a team to relax and feel like,
That is a huge thing for me this week, because it is. It's expend this energy and this focus and this intensity, and you accomplish something that nobody thought you could, and here you are standing here going to a regional. So that is my main focus, is to keep them just charging straight ahead with their head down and their blinders on. So. It's no different than in any other sport. When you accomplish something and you've got to move on to the next thing, we enjoyed it last night, a little bit this morning maybe, but we've got to move now and we got to keep moving forward.
Thank you.
Thanks, you guys.
Thank you.